Hi, my name is Annie McCarthy, and I'm a member of Our Lady of the Rosary Cathedral in San Bernardino. Thank you for joining us on iGod today. Brothers and sisters, I'm so glad you're here. I love today's parable. Let me share it with you. From Matthew chapter 13, verses 24 through 30, we hear Jesus relate the story of the wheat and the weeds. Here's an excerpt from it. The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a man who sowed good seed in his field. While everyone was asleep, his enemy came and sowed weeds all through the wheat and then went off. When the crop grew and bore fruit, the weeds appeared as well. And so the story goes that the workers asked if they should remove the weeds, to which the master of the house said no. He was concerned it would destroy the wheat as well. In the very end, the workers would be instructed to collect the weeds and tie them in bundles for burning, but gather the wheat into my barn. An easy conclusion to come to is this: God waits until all has grown before harvesting. Or in other parts of Scripture, we hear something to the effect, the rain falls on the wheat and the weeds. But dear friends, this is good news for many reasons. We not only get the time we need to grow, to produce more wheat, which is what this implies as well, and to feed God's people. And yes, we as Christian Catholics get these things already. And by God's grace alone, we must add, right? However, the parable talks about the weeds specifically as an attack by the master's enemy. We are talking about wheat, aren't we? And dear friends, the enemy is always poised to muddle our fields with weeds. Satan and his minions would have a field day over this. I think the takeaway from this parable, like so many of Christ's teachings, is more subtle than God giving us extra time to grow so the bad weeds can be gathered away from the good wheat. No, I think it's fairly clear what God is telling us. Know thy enemy, even if you must share the same ground. And stand tall, for with God you will belong to the good harvest. And by extension, Christ's followers would have known that the ground had to be in good shape to begin with. Think about that, my friends, and stay holy. Let us pray. You, Lord, are the ground upon which we walk, upon which we worship, upon which we grow. Protect us always from the enemy. Keep us safe from harm. And we ask you humbly to allow us to continue to feed your flocks with the harvest of your word. In Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen.